In the calendar app you may notice that there are a lot of holidays that you didn't have to put there yourself. They appear just like when you buy a calendar in a store. It's got holidays like you can see here, President's Day. And these are all part of the holidays calendar. In this case the US holidays. You can see it here on the left in the sidebar under Other. And I can remove them from the calendar just temporarily if I want to by unchecking it here. And you can see they all go away. And I could bring it back in to check to see maybe why are so many people off school and work today, that kind of thing. Now you don't have to subscribe to this calendar. You can uncheck it temporarily or you can get rid of it completely by going to Calendar Preferences and then under General there's Show Holidays Calendar and you can uncheck that and it completely removes it from there. You can always bring it back by checking it again. Now why US holidays? Well, turns out it doesn't really mean anything in particular other than that's my region set for my Mac. So if I turn it off here and I go to System Preferences and in System Preferences I go to Language and Region and I change my region to something else. Let's change to the United Kingdom here. And I don't even have to get rid of this window. I'll just go back into Calendar, into the Preferences here and say Show Holidays Calendar Now. And you can see I'm given UK holidays instead. If I were to go and change back to United States for my region, you can see it actually doesn't change this back. In order to get it back to US, I have to deselect Show Holidays Calendar and select it again. And I'll get back to US holidays. So you can kind of temporarily change your region to select another main calendar there. But you're not restricted to just having this calendar or none. You can subscribe to any calendar you want really in the Calendar app because it will allow you to use a URL and pick any calendar that's in standard format. And there are tons of them out there on the internet. So if you want to have another one that's particular to the things you want to celebrate or to maybe a work schedule, maybe your organization actually puts out a calendar that you can subscribe to that shows the days off from work or special events happening at work, you can subscribe to that. And the way to do that is going to File, New Calendar Subscription. Now you have to enter a URL for this specific calendar. So at this point you need to know the calendar URL. If it's something from work you've probably been sent that in an email. Maybe the email said, hey everybody, subscribe to this calendar here and that way everybody knows when things are going on at work. Maybe it's for something else. Maybe it's a sports team that you're a fan of or a part of and they've got a calendar as well or an organization or school or anything. Anyone can easily create a calendar. If there's a website they can put a calendar at that website and you can then tell all your members to subscribe to it. Now you can find a lot of publicly available calendars online. Their websites like this one, iCalShare.com, it's been around for a while. And let's look at an example there. Here's a NASA launch schedule calendar. That could be interesting. I'll click on that and I can hit the subscribe to calendar button, which Safari is smart enough to know that it's something it should open in the calendar app. I'll do it and you can see it pre-fills in the calendar URL. So I'll hit subscribe. And it'll ask me some things like I can name it. So I'll just name it NASA really quick. I can decide whether it's just going to be on my Mac or it's going to be iCloud, which means my iPhone and my iPad are also going to see this calendar. And I can say, you know, I don't want to have the alerts for this calendar. I just want to have the information there. And also if there's any attachments, I don't want those. So I can decide that. I can decide how often it refreshes. For something like a launch calendar, I might want it to refresh every day and I'll hit OK and now it brings it in and I can see it here. It's listed under iCloud since it's I selected iCloud calendar. If I were to select it you can see here there's some launches and some things on that NASA calendar there. I can get rid of the holidays there and you could just see those items. And of course this would be something that would be updated all the time. It's not going to be static for years in the future like holidays, but it may actually just show me like, you know, changes for launches for next week, that kind of thing. So it's kind of interesting. You can find all sorts of calendars out there. So this brings up the question of how do you create your own? And it's pretty easy. I won't go through all the steps here, but I'll point you in the right direction. You can go File and create a new calendar and you can call it like Events. Let's call it Events. And then I can click this little broadcast button here and I can make it a public calendar, and you could see it says allow anyone to subscribe to a read-only version of this calendar, and it's got a URL here that I can copy, and I also can click the little share button just to quickly send an email and click done, and it basically publishes calendar to my iCloud account, and then I can send that URL off to people. So say if I ran a Little League sports team, I was manager of a Little League sports team, I wanted to put all the games on a calendar, I could put them on a calendar, I could share it this way, and I could send it to everybody and they can subscribe to it.